Mike, thanks for talking to us quickly. First of all, just wanted to get your reaction, of course, to that amazing first test match, and particularly the bowling of James Anderson, your analysis of perhaps how skillful a bowler he is.
I think he's as skillful as anyone I've seen, actually. He's a fast, medium bowler. He swings it both ways. And at times, it seems he has the ball on a string. I think he's a terrific bowler.
Absolutely, and of course, started interestingly today. The yes. Aussie seamers came back this morning. Yes. Did you expect that from them this morning?
Well, it's a good pitch for batting, a good toss to win, but there was always going to be a little bit of life in it for a while. And they bowled well to start with, and things went their way slightly, but no, it was a good contest.
Now, I've got to ask you, obviously, as one of England's greatest captains, if DRS had been around, how would you have used it? I mean, do you think it's an easy system to use? Are there tactics involved?
Oh, there are. I mean, I think so far, Alistair Cook's got it right. And the point is you should make a challenge when you think there's a very good chance of winning it, and not if you think it's 50-50 or less. And that makes a great deal of difference. And one of the good things about it is it means that batsmen and wicketkeepers and captains and fielders and bowlers have to be honest with themselves. You have to say, well, yes, I reckon that probably was out if you're batting. Or as a bowler, you think, yeah, I could see it was going down the leg side. So I think that's quite a good thing and quite interesting for the game.
And do you think that's perhaps even more pressure on captains to be cool and make the correct call out on the field?
Yes, but there's no harm in that.
No, absolutely. And perhaps as the two captains, Clark and Cook, how impressed or how have you viewed their performances so far in the series?
Well, we've only just started, I suppose, but I thought Clark was innovative at Trent Bridge. I thought that the whole team seemed to have a good attitude, which one didn't know was going to happen, whether it would happen or not, after all the shenanigans that led up to the first test. And I think Cook's a learner, and Cook's getting gradually better and more solid and sound, and he did most of the right things too. So I think they're good captains, both of them.
And just finally, then I'll let you go. I mean, what is it like, I guess, leading your country in the cauldron of an occasion like this? We all know any test match is an exceptional occasion, but when it's Australia, the Queen was here this morning, what does that feel like? How do you keep calm in situations like that?
Well, I think there's just that extra addition of anxiety, of excitement, of energy, just because of the history and the tradition of the game and the assumptions and expectations of the public and the media and of oneself. And, you know, it's one of those great series and contests where no hold, no quarter is given and no quarter is expected. But on the whole, it's played very straight and you get on with the game, and the attitude between the teams is pretty good.